days go by in the arms of a girl with the indigo eyes. You'll find she'll make you lose your mind in the arms of a girl with the indigo eyes. Dream on the tip of my tongue of spokes and the wheels and the web she spun. Looking too close, she turned me to stone. So neither one said what the other one the time we tried. The reds were drawn, the whites did fly, but the wine filled up in her indigo eyes. On the tip of my tongue of spokes and the wheels and the web she spun. Turning her eyes, she looked pretty stone. So there's flies in the kitchen, they came in through the window from the hole in the screen. No grass on the lawn. And the rain keeps pouring, and the steam keeps rising, and it's hotter than pavement on the 4th of July.
Yeah. Is it Tuesday? Man. How y'all doing out there? All right. Mama got a voice like sugar, it's so sweet and fine. Sister singing Amazing Grace, you know she right in time. They're laying poor Papa low in the ground that he worked and sowed. Now they're waiting at the Jackson station for the train to roll. Well, she been up all night, she got them crows walking round her eyes. She can still raise a cup and a toast to a well-run drive. Well, he left her on a Tuesday still. Gin, whiskey, and a bottle of pills. Waiting at the Jackson station, looking over the hill.
Take me away. Hear the whistle play a sad, sad song. Lay me down where the river runs wild and strong. Sometimes she ride the ticket home. Other times she leave you all alone. You're just waiting at the Jackson station for the train to go. Well, the 419 roll on the red ball line. In the backwater shacks, working on the 419. She got smoke coming out the stack. They're running on a 10-mile trail. Waiting at the Jackson station, never coming back. Jackson Station, never coming back. Waiting at the Jackson Station, never coming back.
Yeah.
Tuesday.
Ha.
Yeah, there you go.
I love it when I forget to turn the reverb off.
It's fun for everyone.
Yeah. And today I've got some natural reverb here in this prison cell of a room that I'm in. No. I'm in moving prison right now. I'm in the middle of moving. So I'm in an empty room with no furniture. But I got guitars. And a camera and some lights and no window treatment, so everyone in the street can just like look in, and it probably looks pretty weird whatever I'm doing right now. But that's cool. It's Tuesday. What else are you gonna do?
It's Tuesday.
Yeah.
Does it look weird like the first time you ever saw someone with like wireless headphones just walking down the street talking to themselves, and you're like, why is that guy? Oh, and it takes you like 10 seconds to be like, oh. They're not talking to themselves.
Yeah.
Having a phone conversation. Now it's just, you just see everybody and that's what you expect they're doing. It's easy.
Yeah. Yeah. It's what we do.
Now, Gordy, so it's like going to be normal on your block for people to drive by and see you streaming through the window just because, you know, that's what we do.
That's what I do.
On Tuesdays.
Yeah, you know, remember when we were on tour in Europe and we learned that in Germany, and actually I feel like in America it might be similar, where people mostly keep their curtains closed, especially in the evening. And then in Holland, it's a very open society, and the windows at dinner time are all open, and you can look inside and see everybody eating dinner and hanging out in their living rooms. And I feel very, very Dutch right now.
I'm all for it. I love it. Yeah. Go with it.
Culture. All right. Yeah. Someone just said, I don't sound as bad, like I'm suffering from the allergies. No, thank you. I feel much better. Appreciate all the concern and the tips on how to deal with that. Child went to New York to start again, running from a man stood 7'2" with a shadow that never ends. Always know who your people are, don't forget where you're from. They lift you up and keep your feet on the ground. It's a fight till the death, then it's done. Come from turn into the world of the underground ring of blood, sweat, beast, and brawn. No one could take Augustinio's swinging, he could fight till the break of dawn. On New Year's Eve, a man brought a black cat to the ring to steal his crown. Augustinio fought that beast all night till he finally put the panther in the ground. Always know who your people are, don't forget where you're from. They'll lift you up and keep your feet on the ground. It's a fight till the death, then it's done. Till he finally called it the legend all were told. Down in the garden there's a 7-foot statue of a black cat lined in gold. Always know who your people are, don't forget where you're from. He was laid to rest underneath that panther. It's a fight till the death and it's done. Come from. Ooh, know where you come from.
Oh yeah, it's nice.
Thanks, dude.
Yeah, dude.
All right, I'm going to do another one off of Stranger. You know, we love that record. We don't want y'all to forget about it. We did release it in the middle of the pandemic, but we're excited. Things are starting to open up slowly. We got a couple of shows coming up here and there. It's very spotty, but a few things happening. And so make sure you keep checking out our website. We will keep updating dates as they become available, or I guess on the socials too. We'll update them there. But yeah, looking forward to doing some shows, obviously. And we got to do a bunch of these songs a couple of times, and they were really fun to play live. So I'm really excited about having some of this new material to do when we start firing up some shows again. So here's another one. Wish I could go way back when the truth was real and I could touch her skin. But I'm caught here in the middle of the world, behind the movers and the shakers and the glamorous girls. Stuck behind the movers and the shakers and the glamorous girls. They don't give a good damn for me. It ain't cool to be blue in the land of the free. Nah, it ain't cool to be blue in the land of the free. I'm stuck going south by somewhere, north by no one. I'm running out of time. I'm missing the fight when I live with desire. Well, I know you felt the same way too. Lost in the middle, there was nothing you could do. I wanna run away, wanna get back home to my sweet little girl and the ones I love. Yeah, to my sweet little girl and the ones I love. I'm done going south by somewhere, north by no one. I'm running out of time. I'm missing the fire when I live with desire. Pick up my life. Pick up my life. Just trying to pick up my life. My
thank you.
Cheers. To Nashville we go.
Woo!
Prost.
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 Lawn chair. Lawn chair.
Slancha, lawn chair.
Skull.
Cheers, everybody. How we doing out there? We're here in East Nashville on a beautiful Tuesday. The weather's been pretty amazing right now, and I don't know if you can hear that, but I think the cicadas are starting here. So we've been enjoying some nice weather, and so I'm making you what was at first a little inspirational kind of. Tried something a little experimental and got inspired, and I'm loving it actually. So, it's kind of a mezcal martini, maybe a mezcal teeny. Maybe. Okay, great. So, what we're gonna start with is a shot of mezcal with the old trusty Bonhez. It's a cheap, like $30, really good bottle of mezcal. It's delicious. Start with a shot here. I'm going to squeeze about a whole half lime. So this is basically actually the real difference from what would be like a traditional martini kind of style is that I'm squeezing a full half a lime in here. So it's a lot of lime juice, but that's okay. It's mezcal, so it makes more sense. I'm going to shake this, and I'll mute myself. Nikki, would you please bring me a chilled glass when you have a second? So I'm going to shake while Nikki brings me a glass here. Thank you. That was very cool. All right, so here we go. I'm going to coat our glass here with a little bit of sweet vermouth. And to do that, you know, you just pour a tiny little bit and kind of angle it a little bit and swirl it around and try to coat the whole glass. It's a good measure. It really does a lot. So from there, I got the coated glass with sweet vermouth. I'm gonna pour this in. It takes a really nice color too, with the sweet vermouth and the lime and mezcal. And last but not least, I'm gonna add a little twist of lime. And you have a really refreshing and actually surprisingly, like, it can be tart, but it's really dry and nice. It's actually super delicious. I would recommend it to anybody. Mezcal martini. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers, Jesse.
Nice. Ooh, what do you got over there, Gordy?
Oh, it's just this classic old fashioned, just, you know,
nice.
The huge, but I'm jealous. I think I need a mezcal teeny.
Dude. Honestly, it started off as I literally was holding both bottles up to my nostrils to try to see if it's very much. It was the most I've ever felt like my father. I was testing flavors by holding the smells up to my nostrils. So, but it worked, and it's delicious.
Speaking of your father, how's Terry Wilson doing? I hear he's doing something on Tuesday nights on the old interwebs.
Yeah, I wouldn't actually know because usually we're pretty busy on Tuesday nights, and maybe that's why I don't quite know why he wants to be our competitor here. But you know what? God bless him, and may the best man win, military.
Well, maybe he's on the West Coast, so maybe he's like streaming later than us.
I really don't know. I haven't seen any Tuesdays with Terry Wilson yet. So,
all right.
Your the mezcal made me think of Ted Lasso. I have to say, Jesse, Danny, the footballer that they adopt about mid-season, they're taking shots of mezcal around the fire bin, and
it's that scene is so good. Yeah, It's a brilliant, brilliant show. It really is, to reiterate.
Ted Lasso, people. If you haven't seen it, check it out. It's good.
That's my new favorite show.
So good. So good.
Yeah, it's great.
The show that we all need right now.
Yeah.
It really, it's like one of those shows that it skates that fine line of being totally earnest without being cheesy. You know, it's funny, it's heartfelt. It's feel good, man. Makes you feel good. Good stuff.
Nice.
Ted Lasso.
Yeah, it's on Apple TV.
He's the soccer coach.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Well, speaking of great art, I hear there's a new record coming out on Friday. Is that true?
Uh-huh.
Yes, uh-huh. It is.
Richard.
Yeah.
What's going on here? The debut?
Honestly, I have no idea. I'm having an identity crisis, apparently.
I love it. So Rich has a new release coming out Friday on Bandcamp. Tell us more, please.
Yeah. Well, I recorded some songs that I really love, and I decided to put them out. So I guess this last year, like, I've just been kind of stuck around and fumbling around with all my instruments and stuff, and I put some tunes together. I recorded some stuff at the finishing school in Austin, and I did some stuff here at home. And yeah, putting out a record Friday on Bandcamp.
You played everything.
Played everything, yeah.
Recorded everything, mixed everything.
Yeah, Jesse was my masterer. Jesse Master.
Yeah. So that's how you know it's going to be really good, is he really went the big bucks way on mastering the tracks. But
you're right in my price range, dude.
They sound good. I think they sound great.
Yeah.
I love them.
Yeah.
I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah.
It's very cool. I mean, it's like Ted Lasso. I just wish there were more.
Thanks, dude. Well, be careful what you wish for.
are you guys frequenters of Bandcamp? I'm curious. Bandcamp's been coming up in our conversations a lot. I've seen,
honestly, the first time that I heard of it, well, maybe not the first time, but Jesse, when you put your record out,
yeah,
maybe it was the first time I heard of it, actually.
Man, I've been using Bandcamp for a long time. They've been around for I feel like they've been around for maybe like a decade or more. You know, it's one of those things where it's like, as much as I would love to say that like all platforms are created equal, it's really not. It's like, it is hard to go that way in like a third party release, because things like Bandcamp are considered kind of third party now compared to Apple Music or Spotify. But Bandcamp is great, and it does a lot of to try to help artists take control of their income via their content that they're creating, and it also does a lot to help people distribute their money to charitable things if that's something they want to do. And it is really cool, and I do, and a lot of people do have, our artists that are on Spotify are a lot of times have a lot for sale on Bandcamp. Our friend James Steinle, actually, he just made a post the other day. Most of his records are on Spotify. I think everything he has is on Spotify, but on Bandcamp, he has so much music, and he posted the other day, it was like, it would cost you $34 to buy all the music he has on Bandcamp, everything. And that's like multiple albums, EPs, singles, and that's $34, and that's $34 that he basically gets. So it's good. Bandcamp's awesome. It's a good tool to have.
Jeez.
It's interesting, because we're weighing subscription service options, and there's Patreon and there's Bandcamp. Those seem to be the two, because Bandcamp now has a subscription service, and we're talking about launching this thing. And I kind of always thought, oh yeah, Bandcamp is more artist friendly, but they take like double the cut.
Well, that's why they started doing those Artist Fridays or whatever, where once every 2 months or something on any given Friday they'll do where 100% of everything goes to whoever's page it is. So, yeah, you know, I will say also Patreon's also very cool. I wouldn't preach one over the other, but I think any platform that allows artists to take control a little bit more so than what Spotify and Apple Music offers is a good thing.
I think the takeaway is that we thought we had our music everywhere that people could get it, but now there are more places that we need to put our music so people can get it.
Yeah.
Why don't you guys in the comments, let us know, where do y'all usually get your music from? You stream, you buy records, you a combination of things, do you download music? I'm curious. We'll take a look. As Gordy's going to fire up a tune here, maybe we'll get a little, some anecdotal evidence.
Yeah.
We'd love to hear.
Says, bang.
Patreon versus Bandcamp. Also, I want to know who out there has actually purchased a used record from Vinyl Richie's record bin at one of our live shows.
Ooh, that's a good, I would be super interested to know if anybody has some of that collection out there.
Yeah, the only person that I can remember is Giannoukos, and he bought like 10 records.
I remember that.
Yeah.
Well, man, should I play a song? Should we get back some music?
Yep. Yeah, man.
All right. Good to see you guys. All right, I'm gonna do one. I don't know if I've done this one on the stream or not, but I wrote this with my buddy Adam Carroll. Manitoba, where the wind is wild on the Hudson Bay. She could have been from Oklahoma if she didn't live so far away. Prairie girl, well, I read your letters as I stood by the tracks of the CPR. Every word just like a teardrop. Every stain on the page, a broken heart. Maple tears in the letters she sends, red like the dirt in the Tulsa wind. It's sweet like cane on the Delta bed. Oh, them maple tears in the letters she sent. Inside 10,000 barrooms, from Winnipeg on down to New Orleans,
And I've seen the arms of that big old river stretching far out to the sea. Of maple tears in the letters she sends, red like the dirt in a Tulsa wind, as sweet like cane on the Delta bed. Oh, them maple tears in the letters she sends. Oh, them maple tears in the letters she sends. I met a girl from Manitoba.
Happy Tuesday, y'all. Betty had a job and was 10 or 4. In walked Betty with a shiny stone. Betty said, "Duncan, you're hotter than red." Duncan shot a hole in Betty's bread. Betty fell down the barroom floor. "Please, Mr. Duncan, don't shoot me no more." Betty and all, women all crying, "Ain't it a shame?" Shot came, Betty gonna shoot him again. Betty had a .45, said he would shoot for half a mile. Duncan, he had a .44, that's what laid Mr. Betty so low. "Done wrong, broken my windows when the gang was going home, knocking down the windows, tear down the doors, 9 lay dead on the golden floor." Old Miss Betty was home in bed, got a telegram that Betty was dead. Said, "Hey now children, get your hats on your head, let's go see if King Betty is dead." "Betty, Betty, Betty, why didn't you run? You oughta not face that .44 gun. Betty, but if, why didn't you run? You gotta face that Gatling gun. Betty, 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 you know you done wrong. Broke in the bushes when the gang was going home, knocking down the windows, tear down the doors, 9 lay dead on the golden floor." Cowboys, the trail, the buffalo. Come a cow, cow, yicky, come a cow, cow, yicky, yicky, yay. If your house catches a fire and there ain't no water around, if your house catches a fire and there ain't no water around, chili out the window. Throw your chili out the window and let the dead gum shack burn down. Come a cow, cow, yicky, come a cow, cow, yicky, yicky, yay. So that was that was my favorite track off of the record we're going to talk about tonight, which is Sir Douglas Quintet's 1970 Together After Five. This is their fourth record. I think it's their fifth record if you include like a best of that came out in 66 that was a compilation of their singles. But yeah, they put this one out in 1970, and that track is called Medley, Son of Bill Beatty, and it's a Doug Somm tune, but it has part of a Lead Belly tune in it that has a couple of names for it. I've seen Western Plains is one title. I did an abridged version because it's a very long song, but anyways, I love this record. It's so groovy, and I love the opening liner note on the back. It says, it's a quote from Doug, and he says, "You just can't live in Texas if you don't have a lot of soul." And this record is totally full of that vibe. Very cool T-Bone Shuffle track where there's a couple of tracks on here where Doug sounds like, you listen to this and you feel like you're watching them at a nightclub, you know, in San Antonio or wherever, you know, maybe a small town on the border. But they do T-Bone Shuffle and Doug announces the tune before they get into it. And it's like you're watching him on stage in a bar introduce a song. And he definitely sounds like he's had a few drinks, but there's a couple of tracks on here where he kind of rambles in the middle, and you just feel like you're listening to them play live, and you are. I mean, you can tell. And these guys look like they've been together for 5 years. But yeah, great band, great record. I added this record to my Spotify playlist where you can listen to it. I didn't see on Waterloo Records website if they have a copy, but you can always call and ask, and they might be able to order it. This may be out of print, but it's on a Mercury like remastered collection of Sir Douglas Quintet tunes that I think is only available on CD, but it's got all their stuff on it, and it's awesome. So yeah, check it out. Together After Five, Sir Douglas Quintet. The opening track is Nuevo Laredo, and it just kills me every time I hear it. Dallas Alice, beautiful kind of ballad tune. And Doug's like singing on this record is top notch. I mean, it's very soulful. So yeah, check it out, y'all.
Oh yeah, love the yeah. Doug Somm. Good call, Rich.
Yeah, dude, this record's awesome. I had never heard it until a couple years ago. You know, I knew like the earlier stuff, but this is definitely my favorite now.
So. Yeah, he's one of those interesting artists that really had like two or three, I mean, maybe three or four even, like, kind of total, like, shifts of artistry in terms of, like, what kind of music he was participating in. There's a really good documentary on Amazon on him too. The name of it escapes me, but it's really great.
Oh, nice.
It kind of talked just about how like he was evolving so fast as an artist, it was kind of hard for people to keep up with it, and hard for hard for labels and hard for promotional teams to kind of promote what he was doing. You know what I mean? Because going from the Sir Doug Quintet, which is like you said, it's kind of like nightclub swing blues stuff. You know, then he was out in California doing like psychedelic stuff for a bit, then kind of came back to Austin, like 69 or 70, and started doing, you know, a lot of his classic stuff, like the his great 70s records, you know.
There's
for Country Rollers and records like that's killer.
Yeah, there's one record, I can't remember the name of it, but it's him and the rhythm section of Creedence. Doug Clifford and Stu Cook, I think. It's so cool.
It's called Groover's Paradise.
Yeah. Awesome. That's a cool.
Yeah.
I think a lot of guys like in the, you know, that happened to a lot of bands like in the early 60s or mid 60s that like came out as one thing and then totally like evolved multiple times into, you know, something better, maybe. I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah. Someone's hiding behind you there, Gordy, peeking out in the bushes.
Oh, who's that? Hey. Hello. Hi.
Say something. Ed, I think Nelly might have something to share with you.
I got a lava lamp.
What color is it?
Whoa.
So the background is purple, then the
lava.
The lava part is like yellow and orange.
Oh, that's a cool one. I almost got that one. When I come to Austin next time, you have to show it to me. I'm excited. I want to see it. I like a good lava lamp. I'm very proud we're continuing the lava lamp tradition across the generations here. You know, it's good. It makes me feel good. When did you get it, Nelly? Did you get it when you moved into your new house?
Yeah, I got it from our grandma.
Ooh.
Yeah, Tui and Pops overheard her asking about your lava lamp, and so for Easter they got the girls lava lamps.
Oh, double lava lamps.
Double lava lamps.
Oh, I love this so much.
Now I need one.
Yeah, you do. Everyone needs one. They're
cheap. I honestly want one.
Yeah, I'll get you one, Rich. They're good.
Thanks.
They're good night lights too, you know. It's just a nice night. It keeps a nice vibe running, and you know, in the winter when it's cold, it gives you an extra 3 to 5 degrees in a small room too. So, yeah. That's awesome, Nelly. Thanks for sharing that with me. I appreciate it. That's really cool. I can't wait. I can't wait to see your house, and I can't wait to see. Can't wait to see the lava lamp. That's very exciting. Very exciting. What kinds of news? Well, I'm gonna play a tune here. I saw Julie had written in a couple times in the comments. This is her. It's her anniversary today, so I'm gonna send this out to Julie. Julie, happy anniversary. This is a little love song called Bumblebee. Be a cold day in hell before I ever walked out on you, baby. And here's something that you gotta understand. I'm a man and man, that's all I can do. And I come home in the morning, rest your weary head upon my shoulder. And one day you'll maybe realize, anyways, this could all be over. Don't you ever wonder why we go around in circles? Yeah, when we both know we wanna fit in a square. Oh, that ain't fair. Don't be the sugar in my black coffee. Be your bumblebee buzzing around. Sugar in my
it. I'll be your bumblebee buzzing around. If I cannot sing my song, want you to get up, wanna sing it for me, baby. And in the times I come undone, you always pick me up and put me back together again. I'll be with you in the summer and the fall. Don't you know, in the winter and springtime, and love I have for you, oh, it's most of all. We've been talking about forever, baby. Don't you ever wonder why we go around in circles? Oh, when we both know we wanna fit in a square. Oh, that ain't fair. Oh, be the sugar in my black coffee. Be your bumblebee buzzing around. Sugar in my black coffee. Be your bumblebee buzzing around. Make it go.
Nice.
Yeah. Happy anniversary, Julie.
Yeah.
I gotta say, I'm on the comments, Jerry Glinzinski popping in here saying that he said, thanks, Ed. I made a coffee mug with the song lyrics on it for Julie. That's very sweet.
Very sweet. All right. I think we talked about that perhaps, Jerry. I can't remember, but thanks for requesting it. Thank you guys. Glad that song's found its way into your life and it has some meaning for you. That's really cool and very flattering. So thanks for that.
You know, this week we don't have a particular guest to interview right now, but we can talk about guests. This month, if you're in the Austin area, yeah. I will be having guests at a little place called Lambert's. And I saw a bunch of comments earlier in the comments about the show that Ed and I will be doing at the end of the month at Lambert's. I guess it's sold out already.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
So you can't get tickets. Don't take my word for it, but that's what it seemed like from the comments. But I would mention that all month is going to be great. If you're in the Austin area, I encourage you to come hang out. I'll be song swapping, telling stories with different friends every Wednesday night. Tomorrow night is our good friend Jamie Lynn Wilson, a guest on the show, on a past Good Time Supper Club. And there's a couple tables left for that one. And then Jordan Matthew Young will be next week. Trevor and I are actually in the studio right now making a record with him. He's you may know him from The Voice if you watch The Voice. He's on this season. But I wanted to also mention week three, our good friend Reed Fail.
Yeah.
Reed Fail will be my guest. And Reed, you spell his last name F-O-E-H-L. You should look him up. If you don't know Reed Fail, we recorded a record with Reed, one of his albums, a couple years ago with our good buddy Steve Christensen. Was it 3 years ago?
I think so.
Oh, man.
Wow. I think it was April 2018.
Lucky Enough is the name of the record.
Lucky Enough. It's one of my favorite records that we've made, I think.
Besides our
record. Or Fab, maybe. Yeah, I like preach that record to people. Yeah, there it is, right there. I mean, it's really one of the, it's a special piece of music, and from start to finish, I really love it a lot.
So we will be, Reed is coming to Austin again at the end of April, and we're going to make another record with him, which we are super excited about. And he will also be doing this Wednesday night Lambert show. And my guess is everybody might be coming, all the heathens, we might all be coming to hang out that night.
I was going to say, there might be a rowdy table in that, on that one.
There might need to be a rowdy table there, but anyway, we'll be there. Check it out if you can get to Lambert's on a Wednesday night this month. I think the last Wednesday of the month, Ed and I were going to do, and I think it's sold out, but, there are still tables left here the rest of the Wednesdays. Anyway, I just needed to get that plug in there.
Nice.
I'm doing my job as the host of the Wednesday night series in, at Lambert's.
I personally am looking forward to that as a guest.
Awesome. Maybe you should do some songs too, Jesse.
Well, I know it's okay. I'll be happy to drink cocktails and watch the pros do it. But I'll be there.
Great bar, great food menu. The brisket there is amazing.
The bartender, the nice cocktails are so good. I mean, I remember the last time I was there, they had a margarita. I mean, it's a badass little joint.
Hey,
it's really cool.
For the heathen super fans out there, the old school heathen fans, little known heathen trivia is that Brooks installed the bar. He did the concrete bar there.
The upstairs one, for sure, I could tell you he did, because I helped him install it, and we all almost died putting it in there.
Yeah, I was going to say, Colin made the bar out of concrete. He measured it and poured the concrete and made this beautiful polished concrete bar top. And yeah, Ed was there. There were a few of us that were recruited to get this heavy bar top up the stairs, like spiral staircase, into Lambert's. Yeah, I forgot about that.
So it's a little bit of it's a destination for the super fan. You come, you have a drink at the bar that Colin helped build, and listen to songs by Gordy and Reed, or Gordy and Jordan.
Dude, it's like going on the Boss Tour in Asbury Park, dude.
It's like going on the Boss Tour in Asbury Park.
The one of the stops is that, well, the heathens actually installed this bar.
cold as Barbie. We could send her in Liverpool or something.
We could send people to Rio. They can go out to that back spot where the pool is, and that's where we all used to hang out, and you know, where Momos used to be.
I hear that John Robert needs a ticket to the show for ours, for our show.
Putting it out there.
I'm trying to understand what's happening in the comments. He's coming in from out of town. Well, if you try hard enough, you might be able to find a secret way in. Let's do we have a video queued up, ready to go?
Oh, we might. I mean, I just wanted to make sure our interview segment was done with ourselves first before.
I think we're done interviewing ourselves. Are you guys good?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm ready.
Do we need to tease this, or should we just lay right into it?
There was a pretty awesome teaser post I saw just, and I think post? That we're ready to jump into it.
All right, I'm gonna fire
all right.
it up.
Cameras off.
You know what to do.
A teaser post?
Everybody, cameras off.
Teaser post?
Falling all around, it's time I was on my way. Thanks to you, I'm much obliged for such a pleasant stay. Now it's time for me to go. The autumn moonlight's my way. And it's headed my way. Oh, sometimes I go so tired, but I know I've got one thing I got to do. Run along. Now's the time, and the time is now to sing my song. Got no time for spreading roots. The time has come to be gone. Though our healthy drank a thousand times, it's time to ramble on. I can do no.
Yeah.
All right.
Nice, Jesse.
Yeah.
Nice
editing. Yeah. Ramble on, dudes. Also, I gotta say, I did make a little note, but that was starring Two Doors Down, my neighbor Don. He's the coolest dude, and I called him because as I was hearing Ramble On and I was listening and putting the parts in, I was like, man, I feel like we got to pull. I was like, I just wish we had, like, Easy Rider scenes. And I called him, are you happening? Do you happen to be going on a bike ride today? And he was like, actually, I was going to ride out later. And so I followed him, or I had Nikki drive me and follow him from our house about 3.5 miles out of town, and then we turned around and went home. But it was worked out. Thanks, Don.
Yeah. It's always impressive to see somebody with the ape hanger, you know, bike and be able to turn it one-handed. Like I noticed Don did a one-hand turn.
He's a badass. So, yeah, it's always on the right, so you got your throttle, because that's the move. The
right. Turn one-handed. That's pretty dope.
The guy's pretty cool. Also, actually, I will say that I was almost gonna pitch it. He's a music lawyer. He would be a great guest to have on sometime. We can get some free legal advice by having him on as a guest and asking him questions. You know,
we'll barter and trade. We'll introduce him as Don from Two Doors Down, not to be confused with Three Doors Down.
Not the band Three Doors Down.
Cool, man. Good video.
Good song. Dude, you guys crushed the Vokes on that.
Vokes. It's fun. It was fun diving into the badassery that is the Zap, you know? I think we all know. We kind of take it for granted, though, you know? But for us, when you kind of going back in and, like, kind of dissecting these songs and pulling them apart part by part, it's pretty you know, some serious high level craftsmanship going on there for sure. On all fronts.
Yes.
Do we have we got some East Nashville happening tonight or what?
Yeah. I'm fully just gonna hand this off to Nikki Bloom.
Fantastic.
I'm gonna go make myself another mezcal martini.
Yeah, will you make me one?
Yeah, coming up. Here's the wonderful Miss Nikki Bloom. Look out for the little charger here.
Yep, I see it. Hi, guys.
Hey, Nikki.
Hey.
Wow, I feel like you must work that song into your live repertoire because it just slays. Like, the vocals, the band, I was like, man, that is some badass shit. If I was at your show and that came on, I would have to, like, make my way to the front. You know that feeling? I'd be riding those rails.
The tractor beam.
Yeah, totally. Like, you're in the bathroom and you hear that and you're just like, oh, I got to go. Good feelings. Good vibes. Man, I've kind of dipped into, like, my little world of you know, I got my first turntable when I was, I don't know, 18 or something like that. And I would go to record stores and go to the dollar bins and actually discovered a whole bunch of artists that way. And some of the records that were a dollar were like Eric Clapton records, which I feel like just that name is so loaded for some reason. Like if you like Eric Clapton, people sort of form an opinion of you in a way. But I was very innocent at the time, and I kind of fell in love with two of his records, one which was just Eric Clapton. So I'm going to do one of those songs. What was the other one that I like?
Ocean.
Mickey.
Ocean Boulevard.
Don't apologize for liking Eric Clapton. There's nothing wrong with that.
Thanks, Ed. It's like I like the Eagles too.
They're great too. Yeah, don't apologize.
I was going to also say that some people just don't believe with religious beliefs because Clapton is God.
All right.
Anyway, this is just a song that I really love. I love the whole record, but I like this one. Here it goes. The rain is falling from the mist of sorrow that surrounds me. The sun could never thaw away the bliss that lays around me. Let it rain, let it rain, let your love rain down on me. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. Like a desert flower burning in the sun, until I found the way to love was harder said than done. Let it rain, let it rain, let your love rain down on me. Let it rain, let it rain, let it rain. When I give my heart to you, you surely give it back. Let it rain, let it rain, let your love rain down on me. Let it rain, let it rain, let it
rain. Yeah.
That was Jesse shaking his cocktail.
But it wasn't
out of time.
No, it wasn't. Percush. It wasn't time.
Jesse down Percush Alley.
It was in time. It was just
I wasn't sure. Okay.
Time is relative. Time is relative.
In your house. That's
there was more there was less ice in it than I thought. I thought it was gonna shake on rhythm easier.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of a latency with the liquid in there.
Yeah, well.
It was on time. It was just out of phase.
That was cool. Great choice.
That was awesome.
Thanks, guys. Really Thanks great. For letting me hang out with y'all for no, the
51st week. How does it feel to be the sixth heathen for 51 weeks?
I mean, I feel like the luckiest girl in the room.
The only girl in the room.
How in this does room, it feel? Yeah. The
sixth heathen. First sheathen.
Whoa, did you just make that up?
Well, I don't know.
No, it's been used.
Because technically the daughters okay. might actually be the sheathens.
Definitely.
But, yeah.
Definitely.
But Nikki's actually just as plain old heathen. Yeah.
Well, I'm real honored. And Trev, I can't wait to see what you got in store tonight. It's always one of my favorite parts of the night.
Boom. Boom.
Boom.
All right. Well, this week it's... I was hanging out today with Brian Blaylock, our buddy, doing a recording session. And the show I have for you this week, he kind of clued me in that this is the show, his birthday show. He was born on March 29th, 1990. Let's see here. Yeah, you get the gist. It's kind of like a weird Eyes of the World there. But the show I am referring to, 329-1990, from Long Island, Nassau, I think night two of three, is legendary. One of the greatest sit-ins, not only in Grateful Dead history, I just say that I'm aware of in rock and roll history. It's up there, and I'm sure like even the writers at Rolling Stone might agree. Branford Marsalis came out and joined the Grateful Dead at this show. He had never met him. Phil was a fan, apparently. Branford lived close by somewhere in Long Island or was around. There's a story out there on it. But yeah, he showed up, played first set, a beautiful bird song. All this is on YouTube, and I think there's a link that we'll post. But played a beautiful bird song that really set the table for what was to come. And then they closed the set without him, and then he came out and just did the whole second set. And they opened with Eyes of the World that is considered by many to be one of the best they ever played. Just a magnificent, towering, beautiful piece of music, 17 minutes long. I know I have friends who have rafted the Colorado or the Salmon or whatever, gone out to Arches National Park, and like this is their anthem for those types of trips because it's that gorgeous. It was released on Without a Net, so it was part of the official release, but the whole show has been released now many years later. But it's really worth checking out, and a lot of people know the Eyes of the World but don't go much deeper, and if you do, the Dark Star that's a couple songs later is also amazing. So check it out, 329-1990, in honor of Brian Blaylock. It's his birthday show. He was born that day, and just a beautiful sit-in from Branford Marsalis. So that's another Grateful Dead minute for you. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Trev.
Yeah.
Remember that. That's one that's always talked about a lot.
Yeah. It's interesting. I was talking about it with Brian today because, you know, we've seen this. We've had people sit in with us. We've sat as musicians and at this long of doing it. Like, you've seen people on stages at shows you've gone to who come out and sit in. Maybe somebody from the opening band or vice versa comes and sit in. And there's like an art to the sit-in that very few people, even really like A++ musicians, some of them aren't really good at sitting in. And I think the real mastery comes from like laying out and just knowing, you know, when you get the look to step forward and say something and then lay out. And this is an incredible, the way he just kind of just infused himself in the music was beautiful. And he's talked about it in many interviews subsequently in his life. And he's, you know, he's such a phenomenal musician from such an incredible family, really just national treasures, the Marsalis family. And he talks about this as one of the greatest experiences he's ever had on stage. And it said he took him back to when he was a kid, like when there wasn't lights and production, and it was just like playing with his family at home and like kind of the purity of music and the essence of what was going on. And that's what it sounds like. It's really beautiful, beautiful document, beautiful show. So
well said. Yeah, he's a total master.
Yeah, total master.
Total master. Thanks, man. Well, we're rolling into the Trading Places segment. And before I do this, I have to wish my brother-in-law, Breon, a happy birthday. It's his birthday today. Happy birthday, Breon.
Happy birthday, Breon.
Yeah, unbeknownst to him, he shares a birthday with one of the greatest country singers, songwriters. Not even country, just one of the greatest singers and songwriters of any genre ever. The great Merle Haggard. And Hag was just, he's a quintessential American. He lived such a perfect life that he actually died on his birthday. He was born on April 6th, 1937. He died on April 6th. I think it was 2017, I want to say. I'm not looking at my notes right now, not very professional. But just know he left the earth the same day he came in on, which is pretty amazing. That's got to be less than 1%, right?
Well, yeah, for sure. I'm gonna guess it's like 1/365th, whatever that is.
To the nth power, though.
Well, 1/365th and a quarter.
Oh, I love when we hit the math. It's always good. Oh, anyways, we're going to play a couple of Haggard songs right now. this first one here is just a great song. covered by, pretty much everybody, dozens and dozens of artists, but I always love singing it. I'm going to do it for you right now. This is Sing Me Back Home.
Led a prisoner down the hallway to his doom. I stood up to say goodbye like all the rest. And I heard him tell the warden just before he reached my cell. Let my guitar playing friend do my request. Sing me back home a song I used to hear. Make my old memories come alive. And take me away. Oh, and turn I recall last Sunday morning, a choir from off the streets came in to sing a few old gospel songs. And I heard him tell the singers, there's a song my mama sung. Won't you hear it once before you move along? Sing me back home a song I used to hear. Make my old memories come alive. Take me away. Oh, and turn
it. I see the Sequestered Songwriters Group did an amazing tribute to Merle Haggard last night. It's a bunch of our friends, Jason Eady and Courtney Patton, I think, started that Sequestered Songwriters Group, maybe. And I think they started the pandemic by doing a tribute to Merle. But anyway, it's been a year. And I'm going to do another Hag song. There we go. Thank you.
I'm tired of this dirty old city. Entirely too much work, never enough pay. And I'm tired of these dirty old sidewalks. Think I'll walk off my steady job today. Turn me loose, set me free. Somewhere in the middle of Montana. Give me all I got coming to me. Keep your retirement and your so-called social security. Big city, turn me loose and set me free. Been working every day since I was 20. Haven't got a thing to show for anything I've done. There's folks who never work and they got plenty. Think it's time some guys like me had some fun. Turn me loose, set me free. Somewhere in the middle of Montana. Give me all I got coming to me. You can keep your retirement and your so-called social security. Big city, turn me loose and set me free. Big city, turn me loose and set me free.
It's a good one too. So many good ones. What a catalog.
Yeah.
If I just posted a link in the comments if you guys want to check it out. It's a little video of us doing Sing Me Back Home at a sound check in San Antonio with our friend Carson McCone. Good times.
Shot by our good buddy Greg Giannoukos.
Giant nukes?
You got it, bro. That's the one. Well, this leads us to the big climactic moment of the night. It's the five-man electrical jam.
Woo!
Or in this case, the five-man acoustical jam. Plus piano.
We're all plugged in.
You're acoustic-ish.
Trav.
We're all plugged in one way or another.
It's a hybrid. It's an acoustic upright, but has digital technology involved.
Fascinating. Very cool.
I'm gonna do this one on the whirly, though.
Ooh.
What?
That's very cool. Is the microphone gonna hear you? Oh, you're bringing it with you. Look at that.
It's a road.
Hey guys,
it's a whirly.
Just wait till Trevor's part, everybody.
Oh, sorry.
You're gonna love it.
I can't believe nothing has been said yet about Ed's mustache.
I know.
I just saw some comments. It looks fabulous, Ed. Nicely done.
Hey, thank you. Now I'm acoustic. Nice mustache, Ed. Now we're acoustic. What?
Whoa.
Did I give it away? Did I give the song away?
Cool story.
Sorry.
No.
You're like a child who wanders into the middle of a movie.
Yep, Rusty said Zappa. So did Nikki. Nikki said Zappa as well.
Yeah, I've got that one before. That's just, you know, it just... I also got the guy on that show that's on NBC. What I can't... This Is Us, whatever that show is called. That dude, whatever his name is. Anyways, I get a variety of... you guys can look up his name if you want. I get a variety of... Depending on facial hair and hair... construct, I have a variety of doppelgangers apparently out in the world. So
Enrico Palazzo?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Pierre Manchego, actually.
No. There's only one Pierre Manchego.
That's for sure. Absolutely.
All right.
Gordy, why don't you tell everyone what we're doing here?
Should I kick it off here?
Yeah.
See if we can get through this song. All right, here we go. The sign said long-haired freaky people needing how to fly. So I tucked in my shirt, hair up in my hat, and I went in to ask him why. He said, "You look like a fine, upstanding young man." I said, "You do." So I took off my hat, said, "Imagine that, me working for you."
Sign, sign, everywhere sign, blocking out the scenery, breaking my mind. Do this, don't do that, can you read the sign?
And the sign said anybody caught trespassing will be shot on sight. So I jumped on the fence and I yelled to the house, "Hey, what gives you the right to put up a fence to keep me out or to keep Mother Nature in? If God was here, he'd tell it to your face, man, you're some kind of sinner."
Sign, sign, everywhere sign, breaking my mind. Do this, don't do that, can't you read the sign?
He said, "Now, mister, can't you read? You got to have a shirt and tie to get a seat. You can't watch, no, you can't eat. You ain't supposed to be here." And the sign says, "You got to have a membership card to get inside."
The sign said, "Everybody welcome, come in, kneel down and pray." When they passed around the plate and they emptied it all, well, I didn't have a penny to pay. So I got me a pen and paper, and I made up my own little sign. I said, "Thank you, Lord, for thinking about me. I'm alive and doing just fine."
Sign, sign, everywhere a sign, bucking up the scenery, breaking my mind. I do this, don't do that, can't you read the damn sign? Yeah, come on. I said, sign, sign, everywhere a sign, bucking up the scenery, breaking my mind. Do this, don't do that, don't you read the sign? Yeah.
Woo! You like my Neil Young there?
Perfect.
Perfect.
That's the Neil Young. Anybody catch
yeah,
that?
Yeah, yeah, the butt
thrust.
That
was great.
The butt bump.
Well, that was a one-hit wonder by the Five Man Electrical Band, and fun tune. Thanks for indulging us.
Woo!
Well,
that was right. Awesome. Birdie loved it.
Birdie loved it. Okay.
51 weeks. We may have something special brewing for next week. Maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah?
Yeah, maybe.
We'll see.
Hey,
we'll
see. Thumbs up.
Working on it. We got the thumbs up sign.
Yes.
Well, thank y'all so much for hanging with us every Tuesday for the last year. 51 weeks, anyway. We feel fortunate and grateful just to have a family like y'all and to have each other. So we'll see you next week for the 52nd episode of the Good Time Supper Club. Thanks so much, y'all, for tuning in.
Thanks, everybody.
Everyone.
Good week.
Thanks for coming out. We're the Band of Heathens. What a place. This is our first time here. This is a classy joint, y'all. Thanks for joining us.
I'm not running to get nowhere. Kicking back to the moon.